These days, mga pork and beef have become kind of expensive, no? So a lot of people have been adjusting. Personally, I love chicken. So one of my favorite cuts is the dark meat. In my home, I always have chicken quarters. So today, what we're going to do is we have three kinds of chicken dishes. One, I have a Hainanese chicken rice. The other recipe is I'm going to make a soy chicken, one of my favorite dishes. The other recipe is I'm going to make Indian chicken curry. Here are the ingredients for our Indian chicken curry. Cooking oil, chopped garlic, chopped onions, chicken quarters, curry powder, water, chicken cube, coconut milk, cubed potatoes, and jalapenos cut in halves. We also have patis to taste and four hard-cooked eggs. When you start cooking something like this, is you can fry just the skin of the chicken, just to brown it a bit, which I'm not going to do because here, it's about simmering the chicken. We have some cooking oil, okay, and we will just start sauteing garlic and onions. So yan, sauteing some garlic, okay. See, increase the heat. So these are minced garlic. What you want to do here is the garlic, you don't really brown, okay? You just extract the flavor, add in the onions. Same thing, actually you're after the ano naman eh. You're just after the flavor, so, and we'll wait for this to brown. You know, by the way, you know, this recipe, if let's say you don't have chicken and you want to use pork, go ahead and do that. You want to use beef, if you want to use beef, then it takes a lot longer to tenderize it. So you, very important is you cover it. So what we will do is we'll add in our chicken. This is a delicious recipe, by the way, and it's so simple. Yan, quarters. Okay. We add in our chicken cube. We add in our water. Okay. And then we add in our potatoes also. These are cubed or depends. You can even have your potatoes smaller cubes if you want that. And then I have some hard-cooked eggs, no? Now, yung curry powder, you have to be very careful with this because when I first did this, I put too much curry powder. So a tablespoon is perfect. Now, at this point, what you want to do is just cover it. Siguro, and simmer this for another, siguro about 30 minutes or like I say, mga 40 minutes, just so that I want it to overcook a little bit so that the tendon or the joints become edible. The seasoning for this dish is just patis or fish sauce. I have here some jalapeno and I'll slice this one just so that it'll add a little heat to it. You know, one thing about having a dish with coconut milk or cream is the spiciness is neutralized by that. We will come back to this one. You know what I did also is I'm simmering it just without the coconut milk. Why? Because the coconut milk, when you over simmer it, the oil comes out. I don't want that to happen. But if it does, it's still okay also. Now, at this point, we'll just taste, though. And remember, the seasoning here is just the chicken cube, right? There's a little taste already. It's a little taste. Now, what I'll do is I'll add in our curry powder. Wow, I love the aroma of this curry powder. Then we'll add in our jalapeno chili. Okay, then we'll add in our coconut milk. I'm going to lower the heat. Okay, now you'll see that when I pour that coconut milk, it's a little bit thick. Mix it very, very well. Yan. Okay, flip over the parts that have not been submerged. You have to look also, you're not only looking at the chicken to become cooked, you're also looking at the potatoes, remember? The potatoes are raw. Okay. Now, if let's say somehow you overcook the potatoes, that's also a good thing, you know why? Because the potatoes will break and it adds as a thickener also to the sauce. Now, at this point, we'll taste a little bit. Actually, it's very good already, but I have a tablespoon of patis. This is going to make this come to life. You know, you have to try this. It's a simple recipe, di ba? You just saw how I made it. Mix a little bit, okay? Now at this point, if you want, let's say the chicken is done already and you find that the sauce is a little bit runny or watery, remove the cover and let it simmer so that it evaporates a little bit and it becomes a little thicker.
okay na.
It's perfect. Then it's a little bit spicy. Then we add in the hard-cooked eggs. If you have chutney, usually they have this with chutney. Okay. Yeah, look at that. Okay. And this one, siguro another 15. You can press the chicken eh. And you will know that it lacks simmering pa because I'm not at that point where it's tenderized at the point that I like it, no? Cook is a different story, okay? But over simmered so that it becomes nice and soft is what I'm after, okay? So let's simmer this for another mga 10-15 minutes. Okay, this one is done. Ooh, I don't know if you noticed, the sauce of the chicken curry has thickened a bit, no? So this one is done. I'm just going to plate it, but let me taste it first. Ang sarap niya. Really, really well done. You know, if you have some roti, you can find that in a lot of the stores now. You just dip some of the roti in the sauce. Winner. Let me plate this. What I'm doing is I'm just plating it. Practically each piece has one whole boiled egg. Okay. And then, you know what you can do also with this? Is you can get a jalapeno sili. And each bite, you get a piece of that. Ooh, a little bit spicy. Patay ka lang. Chinese. But I love it. Yan. You know, any dish that requires a lot of rice is good. There you have it. This one is called Indian chicken curry. Up next, we will travel to an oriental palate and I will teach you how to prepare my version of Hainanese chicken adlai rice right here at Casa Daza. You know what I'm going to do right now? I'm going to make a very popular Singaporean dish called Hainanese chicken rice. To make Hainanese chicken adlai rice, you will need to have one whole chicken, salt, sliced ginger, spring onion, 10 cups of chicken broth, a bowl of water and ice, sesame oil and salt. You will also need oil, chicken fat, and grated garlic. And for the adlai rice, you will need one pandan leaf, broth, grated ginger, chopped or crushed spring onions, more salt, and more oil. So I have here raw chicken, and before I'm going to start, I will remove some of the fat here. Dito sa may, near the opening, okay? Because I'm going to use this to saute my rice later, no? So this is chicken fat. Now, what you wanna do is get some salt, okay? And put it in the cavity. And I have some ginger, okay? And some spring onion, okay? What you wanna do with the spring onion is just, you know, fold it and put it inside. The skin of the chicken, actually, you don't really have to rub it with salt anymore. You know why? It's because the chicken is going to be dropped in 10 cups of chicken broth. What I did was I got 10 cups of water, 3 chicken cubes or chicken powder, and I kept it here. Now, I'm going to put the chicken inside and simmer this for about 30 minutes. That should make the chicken done. And I have a bowl of ice cold water to drop the chicken after 30 minutes just to stop the cooking. Okay, after about 30 minutes, what you wanna do is remove the cover, okay? And I have here water with ice, okay? What I'm going to do is just drop this so that it stops cooking, okay? So iced water so that it stops cooking. Yung broth, this is the broth that I used kanina. This broth we're going to save so that this is what we will use to make our rice. Now, this is the chilled chicken. It stopped cooking already. What I want to do is get scissors, cut the middle because the bones are soft na rin, you know? And then, cut in the middle. If you'll notice, the bone is soft already, you know? And then, you want to remove the spring onions and the ginger. And then slowly, you put your fingers between the bone and the meat and try to debone as much as you can. So what I'm going to do now, I've semi-deboned it. It's a little bit reddish, but that's the way Hainanese chicken is, you know? So I'm going to mix sesame oil and salt, okay? Mix that very, very well. And this is what I will brush the chicken with, because actually the chicken and the filling have hardly any taste, okay? So what you want to do is do this, okay? There's a touch of sesame oil, di ba? Okay? And then what you want to do is flip it to the other side, yung skin side naman, and do the same, okay? The chicken, kaya, you know, it's also very good, okay? Okay, what you want to do is get the breast, very flavorful, yung sesame oil and the salt, okay? And then the breast, and then the thigh, and then let's prepare the adlai na. When I was in Tokyo, I ate in this top tonkatsu restaurant, and it was so good. And then they had Japanese rice, or they had a choice, eh. They had barley. It was like rice, very healthy. And later on, I realized what it was. It was adlai. So yung adlai is grown in Hinilaban Farms in Bukidnon. In fact, the owner, si John Perrine, was my partner before. And I know when that guy gets into something, he does it very, very well. What it is, it's like a rice substitute. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to make Hainanese rice, but using adlai, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to saute. You remember the fat that I had kanina from the chicken? You remember that? Okay. So this is it. Okay, I'm going to extract some of the fat. What I've done is I'm beginning by sauteing the chicken fat, okay, from the chicken skin. Now just extract some of the flavors from the skin. Put a little ginger, konti lang, just to flavor. A little ginger, then a little garlic. Okay. You know, when I was in Singapore, they showed us how to make their version of Hainanese chicken rice. And you know what the chef did, which I don't see anyone else doing, is he put a pandan leaf, okay? So he put a pandan leaf. Of course, that'll add to the aroma of the rice, no? But in this case, we're using adlai, okay? Now, I have 2 cups of adlai. This one has been washed, okay? So you have to wash it, okay? And then we will just cook this a little bit. Trust me, this is so good. So now, if you notice, all the flavors are here already. You saute this for about 2 minutes, okay? Now with adlai, is the ratio of rice, normal rice is almost 1:1, eh? Rice and liquid or water, di ba? With adlai, it's double, okay? So I have 2 cups of rice. I have, siguro, 4 to 5 cups of broth. What I have here is my rice cooker, okay? Turn this off, okay? And I'm going to put the adlai. And then I have 5 cups of this broth. Then, just treat it like rice. The only difference is that this will cook a little longer. Now, I'm gonna make the sauce. The Hainanese chicken rice sauce are 3, no? Yung it's sticky, sweetish soy sauce. The other one is spicy sauce, and the other one is ginger sauce. But what I'm going to do here is just make one sauce, combining chopped spring onions and a little ginger, okay? So chopped spring onions, siguro about a tablespoon of chopped spring onions, and maybe about 1/2 tablespoon of ginger, because ginger has a very strong taste. And season that with salt, less than 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and then I have some cooking oil, okay? What I'm going to do is just wait for this cooking oil to heat up and pour it on the combination of spring onions and ginger. And what it'll do, the heat of that oil will cook the spring onions and ginger, and then that's going to be your dipping sauce. What I will do is just pour this hot oil. See? Now, that hot oil will cook the ginger and spring onion. And this is going to be your sauce. You know, you can even use this as ano, a sauce for lechon kawali. Oh my gosh, di ba? Why not? Try it. Okay, so this one is ready. We have our chicken, okay? We have our sauce. Let's just wait to make our adlai. we're complete. Remember, this adlai is grown in Hidilaban Farms in Bukidnon, and they have an advocacy. Meron silang sustainable practices. The other advocacy is they work with indigenous farmers. Here is the adlai. Okay, I'm just gonna plate it. It's a little bit wet. What you wanna do is remove the cover, let it evaporate a little bit, and then that's it. Now, if you wanna remove the, you remember the chicken fat, you can remove that also, okay? So what you wanna do is just serve it with chopped spring onions, and that's it. So you have Hainanese chicken adlai, and you have the sauce. This is so delicious, and it's also healthy. The final dish for today is Cantonese in origin. I'm very excited to show you how you can prepare soy chicken here on Casa Daza. Every time I go to this restaurant called Eat Fresh, they specialize in mga roasts, eh, no? They have something similar to lechon kawali, and I love that. They have roast goose, they have roast duck, and they have white chicken and soy chicken. I'm going to make a soy chicken, one of my favorite dishes. The ingredients to make soy chicken are as simple as the dish itself. You will need 4 chicken quarters, crushed garlic, star anise, cinnamon bark, brown sugar, crushed ginger, soy sauce, and chicken broth. You will also need Chinese wine, sesame oil, and 5 spice powder. Let's start off with some, okay, Chinese wine, okay, sesame oil. Just mix everything together. 5 spice, okay, ginger, soy sauce, okay, brown sugar. I have anise seeds, no? The anise seeds, don't put too much of it because anise can be overpowering. So I have just 2 stars, okay? I have garlic, okay? And I have cinnamon sticks. Now, okay, we will mix all of this together very, very well. Okay, that's going to be our flavoring already. Then we add in our chicken legs. I have 4 chicken legs. If you want to use a whole chicken, go ahead and do that, no? And I'll show you what we will do after. Then the only ingredient left that we haven't put is the chicken broth, no? Okay. You have to be patient with this dish, eh? You're not supposed to over simmer it, no? Yan, the chicken broth. Yo. Okay. Actually, I have 8 or 10 cups of chicken broth. But you don't have to use all of it because we just want to submerge the chicken in the liquid. Okay. And what I'll do here is I'll invert the chicken so that the skin cooks first. Okay. And just cover this and simmer this for about 30 minutes or 40 minutes, it's really up to you. This chicken naman, I also like to do what I did with the chicken curry, where you over-simmer it because I want to make those connective tissues become edible also. This one is done. Let me turn off the heat. You know what I want you to do? Is taste the sauce, no? Sarap ng sauce. But anyway, this one is normally served dry. Okay, let it drip. Okay, just like this. Just like this. Okay. Why not? Okay. So remember, strain the sauce because you can make use of that pao. You know, there's a little stickiness in the sauce, and that's from the gelatin from the skin of the chicken. Ooh, look at that. Okay. And you serve it as is. Now, if you want, strain the sauce, put a little cornstarch and water, thicken it and serve it with that. Or ginger spring onion sauce, or as is. There you have it. This is your very simple soy chicken. You have to try this. I have just finished 3 delicious and easy to make chicken dishes.
Try this at home. Guaranteed. Your kids will hug you and kiss you and say, thank you. Thank you.
I have just finished 3 delicious and easy to make chicken dishes. I have Hainanese chicken with adlai. Ito, this adlai is like a barley, it's a rice substitute, it's much healthier. It's so good. Then I made a chicken curry and a soy chicken. Some people have told me, you know, you make cooking look so easy, and I'll tell you why. I'll tell you what my secret is. You have the recipe, you have the ingredients, you prepare them, chop them, and you pre-portion them and arrange them to sequence of use. And it's just a matter of assembling. If you have somebody who can do the chopping and preparation for you, have them do it. You're gonna have a lot of fun, because the moment you cook something and you serve it to your loved ones and they appreciate it, you know, the joy is beyond words, because when you see them happy, you become happy also. But anyway, let me try this chicken curry. Like I mentioned, if you have roti, go ahead and do that. You can find that in some stores now, or even yung mga tortilla. Or if you don't have, just use pandesal. Why not, di ba? Wala naman rule yan eh. So some curry sauce and hard-cooked eggs.